Hey everyone, how's it going? In the last video, we saw how to set TDP on the Legion Go for an up to 50 watt while keeping our custom TDP unchanged over time back to the default one. I previously did a similar guide for the ROG Ally few months ago, but the recent one done on the Legion Go has some additions in the smokeless tool configurations to ensure that custom TDP remains fixed over time. So if you've been having issues with the Ally reverting to the default TDP after a few minutes with custom TDP settings, the new modification should solve that. If you'd like to know how to set it up, follow my new guide linked above. I made sure to test this on the Ally as well, and after leaving it in game for over an hour, the TDP remained at 45 watt, just like it did with the Legion Go. This shows that most handhelds could handle 45 watt just fine, provided they have adequate airflow and maximum fan speed. For example, in this test, I'm using the handheld DIY back cover, which allows better airflow for the APU than the Ally stock one. So if you are planning to do this this week, make sure it doesn't reach very high temperature to avoid any damage. However, now that we have managed to set TDP to 45 watt, it's important to allocate it equally between CPU and GPU. What typically happens when you increase TDP is that the CPU takes most of the extra power budget, leaving the GPU with almost unchanged performance. So in this video, I'll show you how to ensure benefiting the GPU more from the increased TDP this week while keeping CPU performance in check. So after setting the TDP with the smokeless tool, as shown in the video guide, you will need to install the Ryzen Universal Utility tool in Windows in order to control and apply TDP in OS as well. I'd like to mention that I kept Armory crate intact without deactivating it. All I did is creating a custom power profile, setting the TDP to 30 watt with maximum fan speed in order to help in heat dissipation. Now the next step, let's open the Ryzen Universal Utility tool, go to the adaptive mode section, and in the basic adaptive settings, you can set the maximum temperature to your preferred limit. I set mine to the maximum 105 degrees. What I can assure with maximum fan speed and good airflow, in my case, it won't reach that temperature anyway. Set the max power limit to 45 watt, which will be sufficient for optimal clock speed, as we'll see later on. Now go to the Turbo Boost Override iGPU setting, and here you can set the minimum and maximum GPU clock. I recommend setting both the minimum and maximum GPU clock to the same value to ensure clock stability, as GPU clock fluctuations may stagger performance and cause sudden frame drop or stuttering. So I've set both of them at 2500 MHz, while you can go all the way to 3300 MHz, but later on I'll show you why it's not a good idea. In the state for CPU, I set the minimum clock to 4000 MHz, but that slider won't matter much as it's not limiting the maximum but the minimum clock. Besides, you can optionally disable CPU boost in Armory crate if you prefer to run it on the base clock of 3300 MHz. In this way, you can lower the power consumption and some temperature as well. Once you made your changes, don't forget to save the profile and click on Start Adaptive Mode. And a nice feature is the ability to create profile for specific games or scenario. So for example, I have a cyberpunk profile that automatically switches on. So in this way, you can customize profiles based on game if it's CPU or GPU bounded, while even changing board consumption if you are on battery or docked mode. I want to some benchmark. As you can see, even at 45 watt TDP, setting the GPU clock to 3300 MHz cause significantly lower CPU and memory clock, giving a huge performance degradation. So it's backfiring on us now. Reducing GPU clock to 3000 MHz. Now this time CPU clock is around 1000 MHz, which is still bad. At GPU clock of 2800 MHz, the CPU one still hovers around 1400 MHz, which is still not ideal, as well as 2700 MHz. Finally, setting it at 2600 MHz for GPU, things start to do well for the CPU as well. Still, I found the sweet spot to be actually 2500 MHz for GPU, which will do pretty well for CPU and memory clocks as well. In this result chart, at 45 watt TDP, you can see that a GPU clock at 2500 MHz gives the best performance out of the other setup, and increasing the GPU clock above this can start to hurt performance. And something pretty surprising that, even with a GPU clock as low as 200 MHz, games still run fine. What I'm trying to say is that a CPU clock speed plays a crucial role in performance as much as the GPU one. Now here you can see if we set GPU clock to 2500 MHz, we see that before shifting GPU clock to 2500, for average FPS, it's 49.9. So that will be our baseline. And if we shift GPU clock to 2500, While keeping TDP to 30 watt, it gives lower performance as CPU starts to suffer from lower clock. So it's not ideal to shift GPU clock 2500 MHz when you are limited by a maximum TDP of 30 watt. Unless you have CPU boost off, which will keep CPU at base clock of 3300. It won't suffer as much in this case. Unlocking TDP and setting GPU clock to 2500 MHz with CPU boost off, it's not consuming more than 40 watt, which will give considerable boost in such cases when game depends on higher GPU clock rather than CPU one. Still, our highest performance setup is 45 watt with CPU boost on and a GPU clock at 2500 MHz, giving us 55 average with improved low FPS as well. So to summarize this, increasing the TDP on both the ROG Ally and the Legion Go allows for higher and more consistent CPU and GPU clock. If you are going to try this week, I recommend setting the GPU clock to 2500 MHz and optionally turning off CPU boost. This configuration provided the best balance between performance and power consumption and heat as well. So if you have any question, please leave it in the comment section. That's it for this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to TECHOSAUR and consider becoming a member if you wish to be on the know for any only video experiments and much more. Thanks for watching and see you on the next one.